If you're looking to buy a laptop under 25,000 rupees, you'll have to make some very tough choices. If you go for the best specs, you might end up with a bad display or flimsy body. If you go for the looks, you might have to work on your patience. Or if you want both good looks and good specs, you will have to increase your budget. Yep, that's how things usually pan out. But this laptop changes it all. Before I get to its name, let me just tell you its key specs. You get a 10th-gen Intel Core i5 processor, a stunning QHD display with 100% sRGB coverage, 16GB DDR4 RAM, and 512GB Gen 3 SSD. It's also very well built with a sturdy hinge, very little flex, and it almost opens up with one hand, which is cool. Now, the laptop that I'm talking about is the CHUWI CoreBook, and I've been using it for the past 1 week. I shifted from Infinix ZeroBook with Core Ultra 9, and initially, there was some getting used to, but it didn't feel a lot slower, and it didn't even crash on me despite all the Chrome tabs that I kept opening. In fact, this laptop handled my workflow quite well, which I wasn't really expecting. But I know, you must be having a lot of questions about service and warranty, and I have a lot to talk about. But first, let's just get to know this laptop better, hit the like button, and let's get started. First of all, this laptop is very well built. Except the keyboard area, the entire body is made up of metal, and as I mentioned earlier, there isn't much flex. It weighs just 1.4 kg, and you get all the required ports on each side. On the left, you get a fast type A port, HDMI 2.0, and a full function type C port. And on the right, there's another USB A port, a 3.5mm headphone jack, and a microSD slot. For some reason, the HDMI port is upside down, but other than that, having a full function type C port in a 25K laptop is something rare, and I totally appreciate it, because you can use it for charging or even for display output. Now, I'm not gonna lie, this huge warranty sticker on the back of the laptop is very odd. But the good thing is, you will be facing this side of the laptop more, so let's just talk about that. When I first opened this laptop, I didn't even know the exact specs of the display, but I remember seeing this. This is so good. It's quite sharp and bright and doesn't have the cheap laptop vibe at all. And then I looked up the specs and well, I was right. It's in fact a very good panel. It's a 14-inch QHD IPS panel with 250 nits brightness and 100% sRGB coverage. The brightness was never an issue as I used mostly at 60% brightness and the viewing angles are also decent. And this screen goes 180 degrees in case you were curious. Apart from the work stuff, I also watched a lot of movies on this laptop. The display is more than good at the price, but the bottom firing speakers don't offer much bass. See, all in all, the display on this laptop is totally top-notch. I say this because displays in this budget usually maxes out at full HD, but they're never this good. Now, the design is really good and the display is the best in segment. Let's see if there are any surprises in performance. This laptop is powered by the 10th-gen Intel Core i5 processor with 16GB DDR4 RAM. It's running on Windows 11 and the only two pre-installed apps are these. And yeah, there's no MS Office here, in case you were wondering. Now, in day-to-day usage, the laptop performs really well. It can easily handle 20 to 25 Chrome tabs, but when I pushed it to 40 tabs, there was some stutter. Apart from Chrome, I had Slack, Notion, and a couple of other apps open in the background, and it was all working fine. The laptop takes 12 seconds to boot up and 3 seconds to wake up from sleep, which is not bad. Although gaming on this laptop is a bad idea, but I did play Rocket League and I was getting 45 FPS in 1080p low settings and the game was playable. And finally, these are the benchmark numbers. The laptop scores quite well in all the tests, be it Geekbench, Cinebench, PCMark, and even Crystal Diskmark. But in comparison to Acer Aspire 3, which is priced at around 28K, CHUWI does fall short. Apart from that, the laptop doesn't heat up much while running benchmarks or intense usage, as the dual heat pipe keeps it cool. Plus, both the RAM and storage can be upgraded, which is really good. In fact, for RAM, you don't really need to open it up entirely. Just unscrew these two screws and you're good. But do you really need more than 16GB? Other than the performance, you get 46W battery with a 65W AC adapter in the box. In my usage, the laptop lasted 4.5 to 5 hours in a single charge, which is not at all bad, but the charging is very slow. It took 2 hours and 11 minutes to fully charge this laptop, which is a lot. When it comes to the keyboard, it's backlit, which is rare in the segment, but there's a lot of flex and the feedback is also not good. Plus, the trackpad is also not the kind that I'm used to, but you do get used to it over time and the gestures work well too. Keyboard and trackpad is one area where this laptop doesn't feel any different than other budget laptops. On connectivity front, you get Bluetooth 5.2 and Wi-Fi 6, and I didn't face any connectivity issues throughout my usage. And finally, the service and warranty experience. This sticker does build trust, but the actual reality is quite the opposite. To check the claim, we damaged the speakers of this laptop after we were done with the initial test and reported the same to the service center. They asked to visit them and we did, but the technician wasn't available, so we were asked to come the next day. The next day, when we called the service center, they told us that the technician will be coming late, so we can send them a WhatsApp WhatsApp video of the issue, which we did, but again, they didn't even open the message. On third day, we called CHUWI again to see if there's any other service center that we can visit, but turns out there's only one service center in the entire Delhi NCR to which we were already talking. So we called them again, and on this call, they finally asked for the brand of the laptop and suggested we come on Monday. On Monday, when we called them again, they said there was no response from the brand, so asked us to check us again tomorrow. It felt like an endless loop. Lastly, we checked with Flipkart to see if they can help, but they needed a job sheet from technician, which we didn't have because technician didn't even take a look at this laptop, so they couldn't help at all. In all honesty, I was really expecting a happy ending to this story because this laptop is really good for the price. It works like charm, and it also had this reassuring sticker, which we don't see in any other laptop, but turns out the service and warranty is non-existent. So in case you end up buying this laptop, you'll have to resort to local shops for repair and support because officially, there's no support at all. If you're looking to buy a laptop in any price segment, it's better to go with the company that offers better service and support rather than going after specs, because if something happens, you're pretty much on your own. I hope this video helps you. If it did, press that like button. Also, do let us know what other laptops should we cover. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.